Hey guys, Thunder E here, and welcome to another gaming video, this time on the iPhone 12 mini and the iPhone 12 Pro Max, both of these bad boys right here. Now, first thing you notice, I'm in a different space because I have moved. This is my new office, and I will give you guys a tour. So it's a bit of a mess right now, there's stuff all over the place, but let's get into this iPhone video. So there are two new iPhones, which you can pre-order today or yesterday, whenever you're watching this video. Comes out on the 13th. First off is the iPhone 12 mini. Mini is really small. I have it in the green color here. It is a small device, especially for someone my hand size. In terms of displays, you're looking at 5.4 inches. Now you're thinking, wow, that's a really small display. And to a certain degree, it is a small display, but it's still a Super Retina XDR display. It's got 1200 nits of max brightness on there. And when you compare this to the iPhone SE 2020 edition that came out this year, which that device is 4.7 inches, this has a much bigger display because, of course, smaller bezels, taking advantage of the square area, you can get more on your screen. So if you're thinking of display size alone, this is better than the iPhone SE. Now, so underneath the hood is the A14 Bionic chipset, which of course powers all the latest iPhone 12 devices and should give us some great performance. Now, when it comes to gaming, I was gonna give you benchmarks, but I could not get exact benchmarks on the iPhone 12 mini because my benchmark application was not ready for iOS 14.2, which is on the mini right now, at least my mini. On my 12 Pro Max, I have iOS 14.1, so thus you can see benchmarks there. We'll get to the Pro Max in a second. Let's take a look at some of the gameplay from the games we have. So starting off with Call of Duty Mobile, showing you the settings, guys. We started the game playing at, of course, the max settings with anti-aliasing on, and it ran pretty well. You can see really smooth. That small screen size is still well maximized though. I do like the scaling on the screen, so the buttons didn't come off huge. I didn't have to reset my buttons, and I was able to play quite effectively on that. Though granted, a larger screen real estate would be nice, but it's quite effective to do so. Now, moving over to a game like PUBG Mobile, played at both max settings of either Ultra HD Ultra and Smooth Extreme, because of course we can do that with our chipset, the A14 Bionic. And I got some really solid gameplay as well. No slowdowns, not whatsoever. They both ran well as you would expect. So I'm thinking it's probably similar frame rates to what we have on the Pro Max, which we'll get to. Now, finally, of course, is Genshin Impact, where I maxed it out at, of course, 60 FPS, highest settings for everything. Of course, you can play lower. We know most devices can do that, but we wanted to see what we can do here with the Mini. And it was able to play, but of course you start noticing some frame rate drops here and there as you watch the video quite carefully. And when it came to temperatures, it ran up to about 108 degrees when I recorded while making this video. The other thing to note is actually it warmed up much quicker than any other iPhone device I've used within the 12 series, where I would say most of the devices in about 30 minutes, you started seeing heat rising up as high. This took roughly about 15 minutes or so. So that is something to take note. I will talk about battery life in a second. So about 108 degrees, probably went up a higher to maybe 110, but in that high range. Now let's move over to the iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now the 12 Pro Max is a behemoth of a device, 6.7 inches. I do like the screen size. It feels actually smaller and bigger at the same time, smaller than 11 Pro Max from last year. And then again, we have the A14 Bionic chipset, a larger display, and also most likely a bigger battery in this bad boy. So taking a look at some of the games that we played. Now, of course, we played those games at all those different settings. I will start off with Call of Duty Mobile, which is pretty easy. Game setting again, right there on screen for you. We played this and we got some really good frame rates, 59 frames per second. Frame stability was solid, about 99%. So that was actually pretty good to see with Call of Duty Mobile. Now moving over to PUBG Mobile, where we had two settings for the game. We'll start off with Smooth Extreme, which of course allows us to play at 59 frames per second. 99% stability. Again, it ran really well, and we got some really solid performance on that. Now, when we move it over to Ultra HD Ultra, which is the maximum setting you can get on PUBG Mobile right now, we're getting about 40 frames per second, 39, 40 frames per second, which is typical at standard, and the same thing we had with the 12 Pro, and that was some really solid performance on there. Now, moving over to Genshin Impact. Now, of course, we played at its max settings, 60 FPS, highest settings for the game, as you can see on screen. We got 34 frames per second and FPS stability was at 40%. This is much lower than I expected. And also you would notice the CPU usage was really maxed out at 154.34%. GPU is about 85.8%. So it really pushed it to the limit. And I will have to say that it didn't perform as well as I would expect it. I think also maybe it's because we're on 14.1, not 14.2. We'll have to wait and see what that brings to the table. But that is what we got for Genshin Impact, and I will test more and longer on my full gaming review. Now, when it comes to temperatures for the iPhone 12 Pro Max, our temps actually were similar to the iPhone 12 mini at 100, 107, 108 degrees Fahrenheit, which is roughly 41 degrees Celsius for both devices. It ran really hot. The only difference here is because it's a larger device, it actually, the heat was well dissipated across the device, so I didn't feel it as much as the mini. So while holding the Max in my hand, it didn't feel as hot as holding the mini in my hand, because of course the mini is a much smaller device. Now, I'm sure you guys are wondering, what about battery life? Now, I did sort of a quick test here with both devices within 30 minutes of gameplay. I would say roughly with the iPhone 12 Pro Max, I lost about 20% battery life playing those games and pushing at the max settings, while with the iPhone mini, it pushed closer to 30, maybe even 35. Again, this is a rough guesstimate from when I got the devices. I will say battery drain was much heavier on the iPhone 12 mini than the Pro Max. So if you're looking to game on this quite extensively, the Pro Max is where you should go. And I'll say for using it for most of the day, just gaming on both devices, the Pro Max battery has now come to 50%, while the mini is roughly at around 30. So take it as you will. That is not an accurate battery test, but giving you an idea of what gaming is like on both devices. Now, in terms of audio, speakers sounded clear, and the gameplay sessions, they worked pretty well. I didn't do a speaker test. If you guys want to see that, let me know. But I want you to just quickly listen to just some of the gameplay from the mini and from the Pro Max, and then we'll round this up. Okay guys, there you have it. That is gaming on the iPhone 12 mini and the iPhone 12 Pro Max. If you have any questions on either of these two devices, let me know. What would you like to see? Would you like to hear a speaker test, guys? I will try and make that for you. It's a bit busy right now, again, trying to set things up, and also there's a lot of videos to be made out there. Also, do you want to see a comparison of the camera with the Pro Max, say the Huawei P40 Pro and the Ultra? If that's something you guys want to do, leave a comment down below. If you want to pick any of these devices up, use the links down below. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and always enjoy your entertainment.